I've been putting together puzzle pieces. It's a lot to go back through with the cards right now, but
needless to say,
I think I figured out the karma in this situation. I was in a relationship. I was in that relationship with my ex. Where I was in that relationship for 10 years, right? And there was fidelity issues almost immediately, like within the first month that we were together. There was fidelity issues. And my trust issues were so bad that in order to make that relationship work, I felt like I had to have rules. I had to make cheating okay in whatever way. And in order to feel like I was in control, I had to be able to do what I wanted to do, and I had to make it known, and like whenever we did include another person or, you know, go on our exploits, it was me making every decision. He didn't get to pick. He didn't get the okay. He didn't get any say whatsoever. I did what I wanted to do, and he had to be okay with that. I didn't ask for permission or forgiveness, because in my mind, if he wanted to be there, those were the rules. And it made it easier for me to know that he was willing to follow those rules. And he wouldn't break those rules, because there was rules. There was contingencies for every situation. And I was always honest. I didn't lie to him, and I didn't go out of my way for anything. But if something popped up, I was more than willing to explore it. And that's what happened when the false twin came in. Only that was like, you know, like I originally described, it was a more intense connection than what I was used to. It wasn't anything compared to the twin flame, but it was definitely more intense than any other connection I'd experienced up to that point. And he wouldn't talk to me about the actual issue. Why he gaslighted me, why he lied about his interest, why he would do one thing and then say another, and make it look some kind of way to other people, and then make it look a different kind of way with me. But from the people that I spoke to that talked to him, it seemed like what he told them was that the issue is that I was married. And I don't think that was actually the issue. But I've been wrong before. And even though I had rules for my relationship and what was and was not allowed, I didn't really consider his feelings about being the okay third party. I just kind of expected him to be all right with it, because I was all right with it. And while I don't have anything other than hunches right now, I think I might wind up put in a position similar to what I put the false twin in. And I know that my reactions and responses are not going to be the same as his were, because he refused to communicate and refused to be honest. And honesty and communication are something that I don't struggle with. That's something that I absolutely am willing to give. And an open mind is always something I work with. That doesn't come with guarantees, but Spirit has made it clear to me along the road that unconventionality is part of this journey too. And that I would always have to live out the situations that I put other people in. It's happened multiple times over the last year. I have been in several scenarios that I created for other people along the way. And I've had to go back and make each one of those right in new circumstances. And sometimes apologizing for things that I've done to other people that I've experienced myself. And sometimes it's been a brand new scenario where I am in the other person's shoes and I have to react or respond differently because they couldn't. But I think that is the karma. I think that is the part that needs clearing. The reaction, how we respond to being the third party in a complicated situation. How interesting. Fascinating, really. I wouldn't have seen it coming. But that is the theme, because the other King of Swords, the one in Georgia, he was married with kids. And I think he was still involved with his wife. And then that happened again with the King of Cups. And while this King of Swords has different circumstances, it's not entirely dissimilar. It's just interesting. But maybe now that I've put some puzzle pieces together, I'll be able to get some sleep. Thanks for watching, everybody. Remember, karma is not a bad word. And having a cycle to clear isn't a bad thing. It's just like our tower moments. When you see one and you identify what it is, you can run at it. You can deal with the problem. You can figure out your solution. You can put it into practice before you ever wind up in that scenario. We have been foreseeing and fixing towers, sometimes before they even fall, this entire journey. It's part of the process. And it's the advantage we have with our tools and our gifts and the support of the people around us that help us identify these cycles. Thanks for being part of the journey. And remember not to judge a book by its cover. Or judge a situation just by what it looks like. There's always more layers than we understand.